There's fresh snow at Loveland, with more on the way this weekend. Phil Lindemann, Crystal, 93 News. 4 inches was all they needed to freshen things up at Loveland. Jorge is in town from Arkansas for a quick, spontaneous trip.
Yeah, we were expecting a little snow, but we didn't see anything on the forecast back in Arkansas, so we kind of had our hopes down, but it's starting to, there's like little flurries down, so hopefully we can get some fresh powder.
Skiing Chet's dream for the first time all season is Roxanne from Evergreen.
Well, I'm just hoping for good coverage. I know some of this will be sketchy over here. Some of these black diamonds. I notice they have some of the blacks open off of Chet's stream. I usually just ski this lift up and down for a couple hours and head home.
Lapping chair 4 is Christian from Lakewood and his 2 sons, dressed as a lemur and a kangaroo.
Yeah, it's nice. It's nice to be able to spot them on the mountain.
So what's Christian and the boys hoping for from this weekend storm?
Give us 12 inches so everything opens up here at Loveland.
A basin picked up the most, 6 inches overnight, with an inch or two everywhere else in Summit. Forecast from Open Snow calls for 8 inches along the I-70 corridor, up to a foot or two down south. Graduation rate at Summit School District is slipping from nearly 95% in 2019 to 90% last year. But that's still better than neighboring counties. Eagle Schools reports a 10-year high of 85%, same as Roaring Fork. All three counties are better than state average, 81.9%, also a 10-year high. The National Repertory Orchestra welcomes a new music director this summer, Michael Stern, a one-time guest conductor for the NRO.
Music can be more than just performance. It can be service. It can be activism. It can be engagement in a community well beyond the four walls of a concert hall.
Stern comes full-time to the NRO from the Kansas City Symphony, taking over for longtime director Carl Topolo. The latest now on coronavirus and last call. Starting tomorrow, you'll have an extra half hour to nurse your beer, wine, or booze at local five-star restaurants. Summit Board of Health has extended the consumption last call, but last call to buy a beverage is still 9:30. Summit County's latest infection rate per 100,000 is 797, with a positive test rate of 8.3%. Summit Medical Center is at 47% capacity. Avalanche danger remains moderate today in the Summit Eagle County zone. Danger will change with new snow this weekend. Check the forecast. In sports, the Avalanche lost to the Kings last night 4-2. American ski racer Breezy Johnson claimed third at Women's World Cup Downhill in Switzerland today. On the men's course at Kitzbühel, Swiss skier Beat Fies won the opening downhill. Travis Ganong was top American in 11th. Racing for men and women continues tomorrow. Tomorrow is also World Cup Snowboard Halfpipe Finals at the LAX Open. Chloe Kim and Brex Taylor-Gold make the start. And in local sports, brought to you by American Family Insurance, the Weiss Agency, the folks at Stephen C. West Ice Arena in Breck have promising news about adult league hockey.
We're hoping that March is really when we hope to get all that started back up again.
That was program coordinator Ben Loyal. Summit Youth Hockey and high school teams are the only clubs playing right now. Phil Lindemann, Crystal, 93 News.